so much misinformation out there. So, and I have no idea what's out there other than the feedback I got from maybe some parents, and it just seemed like it might be time to address this.
The Iowa athletic program goes on rumor control after a major shakeup within the Hawkeye football team. Good afternoon, and thank you for joining us. Now, the team ordinarily would be focusing on getting ready for its Insight Bowl appearance.
But last week, the team's top receiver, Darrell Johnson-Koulianos, was arrested on drug charges. Yesterday, the team's star receiver, Adam Robinson, was suspended from the team. Also, two other players, Jewel Hampton and Brandon Wager, announced that they were transferring from the team. Rumors then started to fly that other players could be dismissed on drug charges.
So today, head coach Kirk Ferentz and Iowa athletic director Gary Barta held a press conference to try and squash those rumors. KCCI sports director Andy Garman joins us live from Iowa City. And Andy, anyone else leaving the team?
So far, no, but the rumors were widespread. We heard everything from nobody else was leaving to 25 players were leaving to Kirk Ferentz was resigning. As it turned out, four is the magic numbers. You talked about Darrell Johnson-Koulianos' arrest, Adam Robinson's suspension, and two other players deciding to transfer. Kirk Ferentz wanted to make sure that everyone knew that's the end of the line when it comes to this story. He was on rumor patrol, and very importantly, he wanted to make sure that all the stories lined up. Darrell Johnson-Koulianos, obviously, in trouble for drug possession. He was arrested last week. As for the rest of the team, those issues didn't have to do with drugs. Pointed out Adam Robinson, the Lincoln alum, his issue was academic issues with the team. That's what caused him to go under suspension. He will miss the Insight Bowl. This entire press conference really turned into a referendum about drug testing at this school. Gary Barta and Kirk Ferentz both being very forthright about how much drug testing the University of Iowa does above and beyond what the NCAA and the Big Ten both require.
Of our drug testing on our campus is education, making sure that our student athletes are aware of the dangers, certainly deterrence. I mean, we'd like to have it in place so that it would deter behavior, bad, poor decision making, but also then trying to get ahead of something.
We are not going to turn our head. We're not going to look away or hope nothing comes along. That's never been our approach. And, I like to hear bad news first. I don't want to hear it on the news or have police officers come tell me about something that's going on right now. That's not a pleasant experience. I'd rather know ahead of time and have a chance to try to fix it.
And, of course, the coach also pointing out the obvious, that when you win 11 games in a football season, things tend to kind of go smoothly. But when you only win seven and there's frustration, especially with all the expectations this team had, little problems tend to develop into big ones. Hence the situation we had not only with the off-the-field issues, but with the rumor mill going into a high drive. The officials also pointing out the university spends $70,000 a year on drug testing, not only for football players, but for all Iowa athletes. It's something they try to stay on top of, and they're going to redouble their efforts going forward. We'll have much more on the press conference coming up tonight on Sports at 6 and 10. For now, live in Iowa City, I'm Andy Garman. Guys, back to you in the studio.
All right, thanks a lot, Andy. Appreciate it.
So Iowa now gets back to preparing for the Insight Bowl. The Hawkeyes take on the Missouri Tigers December 28th in Tempe, Arizona.